One World Radio.
So it's always a pleasure, but I want to get straight to the details on this one. Right now, I'm joined by half of Sonny James and my Marciano.
Oh my God.
So talk to me, Sonny. You're doing something which is responsible, which is called United We Care, right?
Yes. I'm doing this for a long time already. Been in the dance scene for like 15 years.
Yeah.
And I felt it was time to give back and to do something more than only playing and giving passion. Also go to like the fundamentals of who we are as human beings.
Who's this with?
United We Care. It's a bunch of people.
Right.
And with you want me to say all the names right now? Well,
no.
I am.
Well, no. I'm just saying like there's it's a drinks. It's about caring
for each other
at the festival.
Yeah. Exactly. And what we try to achieve is that people. We don't try to bring fear in this festival, but we try to bring some awareness about caring about each other.
Yeah.
So if you see something is going bad, just carry. So we have a great team now. We put together the first time at this festival, United We Care team, and we had some great response of people like, oh, thank you so much for helping me out. People with anxiety, and we had this team of United We Care taking care of them. So we're just starting. And we're trying to create awareness about around everybody who's joining the festival to take care of each other. So
amazing.
To feel safe, you know?
It's about enjoying everything responsibly with each other.
Exactly.
Awesome. Yeah. All right. Now stick around. We'll be back very soon. And then I want to talk about what happened earlier on today. And there's lots to talk about.
We have a lot to talk about.
Sentinel, where did this song win? Let me see those hands up right now, Tomorrowland!
Okay, boys, we're live. That means whatever you say will be heard around the world, just to be clear, okay?
Shut up.
Well, I just actually came from the backstage of the library.
Right.
I met Afrojack, Hardwell, and Timmy Trumpet there, and we destroyed the backstage.
So, Hardwell shouldn't be here, but he's here because he was performing with his good friend, Danik. Yeah. Afrojack's there because he's been performing. Timmy Trumpet came in here because he's doing a back-to-back with Dimitri Vegas and Light Mike.
Oh, my God.
And you, your backs must hurt. You've done so many back-to-backs today.
Yeah,
I
think
it's
true.
Even with you.
Even with you.
Yeah, we had an amazing back-to-back with Adam, and I must give you some love because you have everything to be in the main stage with your presence.
Hey.
You don't see it, I think, but you have a lot of charisma.
No, but we need to talk about the moves.
Today, I felt like a competition winner.
Really?
I won a competition. So just for everyone around the world, we did a One World Radio sound system.
Yeah.
I was lucky enough to come onto the main stage, and walking onto the Tomorrowland main stage, I didn't know what was going to be played by you. Laidback Luke playing on a mobile phone.
Unbelievable.
Okay, so you can't see any of his music.
No, we can fill the whole interview about this.
Okay, but
about the mobile phone. No. Laidback Luke. But he did amazing with it, right? Come on.
Yeah. Well, at least he knew what he was playing.
I
had no idea. Anyway. Then
you did well. You did amazing.
Then you get serious with one USB each, which I didn't realize. I thought you were playing off one.
You were taking my USB out.
I asked the sound guy. I said, "Whose is this?" So apologies.
We're
for
not that.
That
close.
No, but I thought that you shared a USB.
Sometimes.
So now I know.
Everyone is on USB.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I know that because obviously somebody left his on the main stage.
Always.
You might need this for later.
But Adam, honestly, you felt like a kind of pressure, no?
I
couldn't tell.
Only to not let you down and not let anyone else down, but I lived my dream today with DJing back to back with you.
Yeah.
But you did, you did it like forever. I must say, you did it well, really.
Okay.
No, but now we come to your world. You came to our world.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But you...
They know how we feel when we're standing all the time.
Yeah. It was the Daybreak sessions and you got energy. That was... And it's you sense it. Like, and if you go back to your set at the Freedom Stage today, tell us what you saw, because it was...
Honestly, I came in reading the Tomorrowland newspaper.
Yeah, I'm telling you, I mean, let's be serious. I mean, when we walked in the Freedom Stage, I was blown away. I mean, I heard of it, I've never been in it. So when I walked in, I said, it's a full-on venue. It looks like the Ziggo Dome in Amsterdam.
It's three layers
it's
high.
It's almost 20,000 people.
Yeah.
It was a serious festival going on. So my perception was different when I walked in, and I was, okay, focus. This is a real big show.
The lights, the screen behind you.
The energy and atmosphere was just amazing. Really good.
It's that big, but it felt so intimate also, you know?
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
True.
It felt really intimate. You could see everyone. Everyone was really into it. I didn't expect this. This was our first time playing inside in Tomorrowland.
Well, I think you played at the old one, maybe. Is that a
long time ago?
This is new.
Very old.
Well, no, the stage. The stage, not us.
So it was the capture stage, not a freedom stage.
Wow. Yeah, no.
I'm sorry.
Way back.
Way back.
Anyway.
Way back.
Your set
was
serious.
Like, thank you.
Then you stick around, and then what happens?
It was a size 20 years anniversary. We did some tracks on the label of Steve, I think 4 or 5 tracks. And he invited us to play the second hour with him to back to back. And that was just a full circle moment for us, because Steve, I mean,
Hang on.
Your microphone's just broken.
Oh.
Carry on.
I mean, it was a full circle moment for us, because Steve, when we start like blowing up in Holland, he picked us up and put us on Ibiza with the Swedish House Mafia. To be here with the 20 years anniversary of Size was crazy, and the energy was just, I mean, if you were there, the whole Freedom Stage was cracking. It was great. It was crazy.
That looked like you having the time of your lives.
Amazing. Yeah.
No, it's dreams coming true. You know, you're just together with Steve Angelo on some stage in Tomorrowland. It's crazy. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it was a full circle moment. What I say, we love the guy to death. I mean, he gave us a big opportunity. We took it to be on to share the stage with him on his 20 years anniversary with his label on Tomorrowland. Come on, that's for us. It's like full circle. You know?
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Look. There's too much to talk about. I'm not going to overload you, because I know it's the final hours of day three on weekend two.
I had some Havanas.
a lot of them. Anyway, the Amazon project.
Yes.
That went well.
Amazing. I mean, we did a Crystal Garden. Yeah. To be honest, the funny thing about this is we thought the Freedom Stage gig was the Amazon Project gig.
Okay. All right.
So we walked in, and then we found out, like, I think an hour before our set, and we went in, and we did what we wanted to do with Amazon Project, and
yeah.
It felt like...
No. Wait.
Okay.
We did the Crystal Garden a couple times already, like two or three times.
With Sexy by Nature, yes.
And now we're back. We went back with the Amazon Project, which Sonnery didn't know. I was prepared. And then we came in.
Your USB was loaded.
But honestly, we just came in and we did what we do and had fun.
Yeah.
And it was, you know,
the energy was
a word and amazing.
Yeah.
It was really amazing.
And for me personally, to have my son,
yes,
12-year-old son was there with me in a DJ booth, and to have him witness like the Amazon Project when we started, he wasn't even alive yet. Mm-hmm. To have him there was an emotional moment for me. So it was one of the best sets I did on Tomorrowland.
Are you happy for him to become a DJ in the future?
Excuse me?
Are you happy for him to become a DJ in the future?
No. It's weird, right? I mean, of course I would be proud, but I feel like he has something else to give to this world.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good.
Something else.
Yeah. I'm going to let you go, but first, Tomorrowland Brazil.
Are you ready?
Oh.
Are you ready?
Are we going to talk about this, Adam?
Are you ready, Adam?
Really?
I'm so excited. I'm like, I can't even explain how excited I am that we go back to Brazil. The last time was 2015, 16?
Yeah.
I forgot.
No, but honestly, you know, we're playing here around the festival and we see all these Brazilian flags. Every time I see a Brazilian flag, I think about Tomorrowland Brazil, which is going to be happening. And I can't wait. Yeah.
Do you know what? Tomorrowland Brazil is your energy. I've not been, but I guess, and I'm sensing that there's a certain circle in a circle moment happening soon.
Exactly. I get goosebumps thinking about it and just seeing it in my head right now is going to happen. And I think the Brazilians, they're so thankful that we're coming back with Tomorrowland. It's going to be crazy. The energy is going to be bananas. It's going to be crazy. Really good.
All right. Now it's party time, so you're free
to
go.
Thank you so much for having us, Adam.
Always.
And again, to share the stage with you this afternoon was a bucket list thing for us as well. Thank you.
It was just a beautiful moment for me.
Yeah.
So as well for you. And obviously, this goes into my top three moments at Tomorrowland ever. So thank you for helping me.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you, Adam.
Appreciate it.
We've got much more to talk about, but right now we have to go back to the Tomorrowland main stage because that's what it is all about here on day 3, weekend 2.